If you've heard that Mucinex can help you get pregnant and you're curious if that's really true, you are going to want to watch this video. I'm Dr. Lora Shahine. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I am a board-certified reproductive endocrinologist helping people build families for over 15 years. And I get asked about Mucinex a lot, whether it's from my patients or whether it's on Instagram or TikTok. I often get tagged in videos, especially on TikTok, where people say, hey, this video says Mucinex is going to work for me. Is that true? Here's an example. And so this video is just gold. It's, you know, looks like a young mom holding her baby. You can kind of imply that she worked really hard, had infertility, maybe spent money on treatments. And she's kind of like, wait a minute, all I had to do was take Mucinex and I could have avoided all this trouble. And I said in the video, and I put this on social media, just kind of saying like, this is totally relatable. This is a great video, but really you got to learn a little bit more about Mucinex. It's just not that simple. So in this video, we are going to cover everything about Mucinex. We're going to learn what Mucinex is. We're going to learn why people think that Mucinex can help them get pregnant. We will review the evidence and the research around Mucinex and fertility. We're going to review the pros and cons of using Mucinex. I asked people on Instagram and TikTok, like, hey, I'm going to research. I'm going to do a YouTube video on Mucinex. What questions do you have? So at the end, we're going to make sure that I answered most of the questions and then stick around to the end of the video because I'm going to tell you what I really think about Mucinex as a board certified fertility doctor. First of all, what is Mucinex? Mucinex, also called guaifenesin, is an over-the-counter cough medication. It is designed to and is advertised to thin mucus in the lungs and help decrease chest congestion when someone has a bad cold. So it supposedly breaks up the mucus and makes it easier to cough it up and kind of clear that congestion. There are many forms of Mucinex that you can buy at the store. No prescription necessary. It can be liquid, it could be pills, it could be little packets, granular packets. It's important to know that Mucinex is not FDA approved to be used for fertility. So if you're using it for anything other than cough or breaking up chest congestion and mucus, then you're using it off label. It just means that it hasn't been studied or proven to the FDA that it should be used for improving fertility. So why do people think that Mucinex could help fertility? Well, the thought is that if Mucinex can thin mucus in the lungs, maybe it could also thin cervical mucus. And cervical mucus is really important for getting pregnant. The amount and consistency of cervical mucus changes throughout the menstrual cycle so that when estrogen levels are high, which is around the time of ovulation, your ovaries are making more estrogen around the time of ovulation, those high levels of estrogen make certain changes in your body, including increasing the production of and changing the color and consistency of cervical mucus. There's a lot of great information on learning about your cycles or sort of natural fertility planning. A wonderful resource is the book Taking Charge of Your Fertility by Tony Weschler. You can learn a lot about what changes in your body depending on what hormone levels are there and where you are in your cycle. But around ovulation, which is when you should be trying to conceive, if you want to get pregnant, the cervical mucus, again, will increase in quantity and it'll get thinner and it'll get stretchy and it'll become clear in color. It's described as egg white in consistency and color. So imagine breaking open an egg and just looking at the white part, not the yolk, and the sort of stretchiness and thinness and white color. That is what cervical mucus should look like with high estrogen levels around ovulation. And so the thought is well, if I need thin cervical mucus to help get the sperm through the cervix and into the uterine cavity, up into the fallopian tube to meet the egg in order to get pregnant, well, if I could thin the cervical mucus, maybe that's going to make it easier for me to get pregnant, like more sperm could get through, or it's going to be easier for the sperm to get through. So that's the theory, that if this medication, this over-the-counter medication, Mucinex, if that can thin mucus in the lungs, maybe it can thin cervical mucus, and maybe that'll improve the chances of getting pregnant. So what does the evidence show? Honestly, there's not a lot of evidence. And the one study that came out in 1982, over 40 years ago, it was published in the Fertility and Sterility Journal, only looked at 40 patients and trying to figure out if Mucinex could help cervical factor for infertility. So this study included looking at 40 couples, male, female couples that were trying to conceive. They've been trying for over 10 months. And back in the 80s, a fertility test that was done quite often is something called the postcoital test. I haven't done this test since fellowship. That was quite a long time ago. But what it is couples would be instructed to have intercourse, and then the female partner would come into the clinic and the doctor would get a little sampling of the cervical mucus and look at it under the microscope in the clinic and see, hey, how is the sperm swimming? And if sperm were moving around and really, you know, looked active, then that was a normal test. But if the sperm were not swimming well, women were told that they had hostile cervical mucus, and that was one of the reasons they were not conceiving. People do not do this test anymore. I actually think it's pretty inflammatory. Like, it kind of goes back to, oh, there's nothing wrong with the sperm. It must be the cervical mucus that is obviously the problem here, because fertility totally is all about people with uteruses and ovaries. So we don't do that test anymore. It's absolutely been proven that it does not predict function of the cervical mucus, et cetera. But when you're looking at a study that was published in 1982, this is what they did. So these 40 couples have been trying to conceive for about 10 months. They did a postcoital test, and it was determined that these women had hostile cervical mucus. So in this study, the female patients were given Mucinex 200 milligrams three times a day, starting on cycle day 5 or 6 after the start of their period, all the way through what they think is ovulation. So they were doing basal body temperature taking. And when you see a rise in your basal body temperature, that means that you've ovulated. So I have a whole video here on how to tell if you're ovulating. After you ovulate, your ovaries start making progesterone, and that increases your basal body temperature. So when you have that increase, you know that you ovulated a day or two before. So the patients were taking Mucinex basically towards the end of their menstrual period through the time leading up to ovulation and through ovulation. And they happened to be taking it 200 milligrams three times a day. And the results of the study showed that the people that took the Mucinex had improved cervical mucus. Their mucus was less hostile. I still can't believe that they used that medical term. And 40% of the patients got pregnant while they were taking the Mucinex for a couple of months. So I'm so happy that 40% of the patients got pregnant. I'm not sure if it was the Mucinex or not. This is really a very poor study. It's over 40 years ago. It's only 40 patients. It's an observational study, so everybody got the same intervention and they were just sort of seeing what happens. It's using a test that has been proven to not be valid and not used anymore, the postcoital test. And really the best kind of studies are not observational. It's better to compare two groups that are very similar, like an age or causes of infertility, length of infertility, and then one group gets the intervention like Mucinex and it compares to the other group that doesn't get the Mucinex. But I think that this is the study that people are talking about when they say, hey, try Mucinex. It has been shown to be helpful, but wow, this study is over 40 years ago and it's really not a great study. So that's what we have for female fertility. What about male fertility? There is one case report in the literature. It was published in 2021, where one person, one man with poor sperm count and poor motility, was given Mucinex for 2 months, and he repeated his semen analysis, and apparently all the parameters improved. So this is all we have for as far as studies looking at Mucinex for male fertility. It's interesting that one person wrote this up and kind of saw this observation, but you can't use a case report with one person to all of a sudden change recommendations or clinical practice. It's interesting, but you know, what else did that person change in those 2 months? And everybody knows that semen analysis can kind of vary over a couple of months regardless. So was it the Mucinex? Maybe, but it's hard to prove without better studies. So we've reviewed the evidence. Now, what are the pros and cons of taking Mucinex? So recent people think like, well, let's just take Mucinex is because it's something that you can get at the drugstore. No prescription necessary. It's relatively inexpensive. And people sort of say, well, gosh, I mean, I want to do anything. Like, look, I'm taking my prenatal vitamins. I'm doing all these supplements. I'll just try Mucinex. I just want to do everything that I can. I just want to get pregnant. And it's cheap and easy and I can get it anyway, so kind of why not? So those are sort of the pros. So what are the cons of Mucinex? Number one, there are side effects. Headaches, nausea, and vomiting have been reported. And in rare cases, some people have had significant allergic reactions, including anaphylaxis, requiring having to go to the hospital. So that is very rare, but it has been reported. Another con is, as a fertility doctor, I worry about people following trends on social media or recommendations from friends that just delay diagnosis of something that we could help. Meaning, I don't want people to take Mucinex for 6 months to a year, especially if they're over the age of 35, and then they come to see me and we find out their fallopian tubes are blocked or there's a really low sperm count. And you kind of think to yourself, oh my gosh, that's a whole year that we could have known this earlier. So I don't want it to be a substitute for seeing a fertility doctor and getting an evaluation. And then I also want people to be aware that this is not a proven treatment, and there are other options out there for treatment that could be much higher chance of success. So did I get to all those questions that people asked on Instagram? Let's take a look. Do both partners take it? So we talked about there's at least one study for both female and male partners, and we reviewed that. Listen, I've taken so much Mucinex, I actually got pregnant when I stopped taking it. Sperm analysis showed viscous sperm. We both tried it, got pregnant on the cycle that we forgot to take it. Okay, so there's two of those there. Mucinex before a frozen embryo transfer. I don't think that that necessarily makes sense. Like with a transfer, you're going past the cervix. So whatever's going on with the cervical mucus, it probably wouldn't help. But I don't have evidence either way. Oh, and a couple of people talked about taking Mucinex and getting a really strange odor. I'm curious if you found that too. Let me know in the comments. And then more like which days to use it. So we answered that just from that one study. And is it beneficial or proven? So we talked about that. And then again, it made me smell terrible. I'm curious about that. I have not heard that from patients. So let me know if you are aware of that as a side effect too. So recap, we've talked about what Mucinex is. We've talked about the theory around why people think that it might help with fertility. We have reviewed the evidence. We answered questions from Instagram, and please put questions here in the comments because I think it is so fun to talk about what you want to learn about. And finally, so what do I think? Well, as a fertility doctor, I want to recommend things to my patients that are proven to be beneficial. Always talk about the pros and cons. I have never recommended Mucinex to my patients. There is just really not great evidence for it. I think it's unlikely for it to cause harm, but there are some side effects and there's rare cases where people have an allergic reaction. And I really don't want it to delay care. I would rather people think about other ways to optimize their lifestyle and kind of timing intercourse, making sure they know how to ovulate and seeing a fertility doctor for an evaluation. It does not mean that you have to do treatment, but it's really important as early in the process as possible to get the testing to make sure you're not missing anything. I have a great video here on YouTube called Baby Making Sex, which kind of goes over some really good tips on when you're just getting started, how to time things, learn about your cycle, and really help you a lot. I think that video is going to help you a lot more than Mucinex. I hope you learned something today. I really enjoyed researching this topic, and the topic came from your questions. So like this video if you learned something, comment with questions that you have and topics that you want me to cover, subscribe to this channel, and stick around for more learning.